trying for his fourth straight win in this event.
So that was Sedeno Chara in a skills competition, and he shot 105.9 miles per hour. So that was, you know, we all understand velocity. And remember, in this unit, there's a couple ways to sort of define velocity. So one of it is the calculation, such as 105.9 miles per hour. But another way is to put it in a graph. So that's called a VT graph. So if we were to sort of graph the motion, say of his slap shot or of your movement, or you in the car, what would that look like in a graph? To start off with that, at this point, you should sort of understand what a displacement time graph is. If you haven't, you might want to check out the previous video. But a velocity time graph, basically, as you can see on the screen, you're graphing velocity and time. So just to recap, this time, this is on the x-axis, and this is on the y-axis. And it's really important for you guys to understand this, because what you do in math class sort of relates with this as well, because what you're graphing is basically the same stuff you have learned in math with graphing with x and y axis. So to kind of give you an idea of how to sort of think about any of these graphs, whether it's DT, VT, or acceleration time graph, well, look at your units, the quantity here. You have velocity and time. So basically, you're looking at the relationship between velocity and time. Remember, at the zero mark, this is 0, 0. So basically, that's your starting point. And as you go up here, this means that you're increasing your velocity. So that's sort of easy to understand. You're increasing velocity. And as you're increasing time, you go into the right. So this is increasing time. The only confusing part is when you kind of put these two things together, because velocity and time, they're actually in relations with each other when you're measuring motion, because once something's moving, your time continues because time doesn't stop. So that's why we always have this time on the x-axis. And then we're going to look at what happens after every minute or every second, what happens to the velocity. So there are a couple of things that you have to know for a VT graph. So let's just say, for a zero velocity, that means you're not moving. So if you think about, move the screen here out of the way. If you're, say, this turtle, look at this turtle right here, a purple turtle, a very nice one. And if this is the starting point, this is my sort of my race, this is my start. If it is at zero velocity, that means you start the timer and the time is ticking, 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 and zero velocity. Well, you can see that, well, the velocity on the y-axis is always going to be at this point. So that's my zero velocity, flat line right at zero on the y, okay? And then once the turtle starts moving at a constant velocity, let's just say that this is a constant velocity. So what that means in constant velocity is that you're not accelerating or you're not decelerating. That means you're not speeding up or slowing down. Basically, it's just like this is constant, right? This is a constant motion. Basically, the distance this pen is covering is the same from the starting point, the same at this point, same to the end point. They're all the same. So that's your starting point. I mean, that's your constant velocity. It's constant. So if my constant velocity of this turtle is at 5 meters per second, if you want to understand this and see, is your line at a slope, a diagonal line, a curve, or a straight flat line, just picture this. Take your time, say at the beginning of your movement, say at 0.5 seconds. And then if you're looking at, say, to the 10 second, did your velocity change from 5 seconds to the 10 second mark? Well, it didn't, because if you look at this pen, well, right now it's not very constant. Okay, let's get it constant. I'm like mesmerizing, hypnotizing you. Here is the constant at this point, at this point. So if you look at the time, if this is 5 seconds and if this is 10 seconds, well, at 5 seconds, what is my velocity? 5 meters per second. So it's at this point at 5 meters per second. Well, that's really messy. And then what about my 10 seconds? Did my velocity change? No, my velocity is still at 5 seconds. That's why when you're at constant velocity in the VT graph, it is a flat line. Okay, so what happens when you're accelerating? So when you're accelerating, acceleration basically you're covering more, your velocity is increasing after every unit of time. So every second, every hour, you're increasing in your speed. So instead of like this constant thing, you're basically going from slow to fast. So after every point, it gets faster. So if it's accelerating, let's look at the time. Let's say you're starting at 10 seconds and your velocity is 5 meters per second. So this is at here. And if we go and look at 12 seconds around here, it's not at 5 meters per second anymore. It's gonna go up to maybe say 7 meters per second. And if we keep going to 14, it's gonna be 9 and et cetera, et cetera. You're gonna see that you're gonna have a straight slope. So that's your diagonal line. So this is showing that you're going up in velocity after every time. So at this point in time, right here at 10 seconds, it's here. If you go move seconds past, wait a minute, you're actually going faster. And you're going faster, and you're going faster. That's acceleration, okay? And if you want to look at something that, what if there's a faster acceleration? Well, then you just look at your y-axis. So at point 10 seconds, you're at 5 meters per second. At 12 seconds, instead of having it at 7 meters per second, perhaps you have it at 10 meters per second. So you can notice if I were to connect the dots, my slope is a lot steeper, but it's still straight. Well, it's sort of straight. So the faster your acceleration, the steeper the slope. If it's a flat line on velocity, that's your constant velocity. And if it's at zero, at zero. So then what about if we were to have a line that's gonna go down this way? That's sort of the confusing part. So let's use our same logic and look at this. What it, at this point in time, let's say this is my 16 seconds, what is my velocity? Let's say it's 10 meters per second right here. And at this point, about 25 seconds, about approximately, what is my velocity? About 2 meters per second. So did I increase in speed? Was my velocity the same? Well, you can see that you went from 10 to 2 meters per second. That means that if you have a negative slope, you're slowing down. Because you're slowing down, you're going from a fast velocity to a slow one. That's slowing down. So it's kind of really easy to get these VT graphs confused with the DT graphs because they sort of have the same sort of patterns and you have slopes, but try to understand what you're graphing. In a VT graph, you're looking at the velocity. So velocity is how, you know, how quickly you're moving, and then look at it per time. So if you have it at this point, at 5 seconds, okay, my velocity is at 5 meters per second. And I let the time go for 5 seconds, at 10 seconds, I'm still at 5 seconds, so this is a constant velocity. If you look at here, this is 10 seconds, this is 16 seconds, you can see that I have increased, and from here I go from 10 meters per second, I decrease to 2 meters per second, that means I'm slowing down. Okay, so that's the gist of VT graphs. Let's try another example. Let's insert a blank page here. What if I were, this is going to be something a little bit different. What if I were to have a line that was below my zero axis? So my velocity here would be negative 2 meters per second. This is still time. Well, this is still a constant velocity because at this moment right here is negative 2 and this is negative 2. It's just the difference here is instead of my turtle going this direction, the positive direction, I'm actually now the turtle is moving backwards like moonwalking that way. So this is would be your negative meters per second. Okay, what about if I were to have a slope that goes like this now? Bam, slowing, going the opposite way. Remember when we had a line that was like this and up, this was a constant velocity and then this would be accelerating. So what about if it's gone the other way? Well, let's use that logic again. At this moment of time, let's say this is 10 seconds, and at the end, this is 20 seconds, compare the velocities. At this point, it's at negative 2 meters per second. And at this point, if you can see, well, it's a lot lower, so maybe this is negative 10 meters per second. So I'm accelerating. This is accelerating in which direction? Are we accelerating to the right, to the positive, or to the left? Well, you can see that it's getting more negative, so it's accelerating to the left, making it more faster, going the opposite way. And finally, we have the last one where we go towards the origin like that. So then, crap, what did we do here? Again, use the same logic. At this point, at 20 seconds, I have 10 meters per second. And say at this 60 seconds, I have 0 meters per second. What happened to my velocity? I went from 10 meters per second to 0 meters per second. So that means you're actually coming to a stop. You're slowing down. So which way are you slowing down? You're actually now, this is a vector thing because it's velocity. You're slowing down towards the origin. So the turtle might have, let me see if I can select my turtle. The turtle might have, well, that's not the whole thing. The turtle will be coming to a stop towards the origin. So to recap, constant velocity below the y-axis will be constant velocity going this way. And then this negative slope would be speeding up negative direction. And then this one going back towards the origin is actually coming to a stop and stop right at the origin. That is a very confusing concept. So hopefully with that logic, try to play around with the numbers. Try to use one point in time, the next point in time, and see how that works. Okay, so that's your VT graph. Hopefully this sort of gave you an idea of how to look at a VT graph, and I also compare it to a DT graph because it's really important for you to see the differences between a DT, a VT, and an AT. So let's look at that on a moving man. This is a great app, and let's check that out. This is your moving man. Again, we are using this because it's very helpful, and I'm going to take away all those walls. You can see the man is at the origin of 0, 0. And position is at zero velocity, so we're not going to look at the acceleration. So the first thing we want to look at is at zero velocity. So zero velocity, we're going to just press play. You can see both of my position and velocity is going to be at zero because you didn't move, so it's at zero. And because you didn't move, your velocity is at zero. So what happens when we have a constant velocity, let's say 2 meters per second, you can see that it is a flat line. Right, it's a flat line because at this point in time, with the logic from before, it's at 2 meters per second. And later on at 4 seconds, it's still at 2 meters per second because he's not accelerating. But how is this different in a position time graph? Well, because he's moving, remember the guy is moving away, he's moving away from the origin. So at this point, he's at zero. As he's moving here, he's moving away from the zero. That's why there is a slope. So then what happens when we have a negative velocity? So negative 2, you can see quickly he's moving back to the origin. So right now he has moved back to the origin. You can see that in your position time graph, right? In the beginning of when we before we press play, he's at 4-ish around here. After a couple seconds, he's back at origin. So this is your negative slope. And then here at the velocity is going to be your negative 2 because this is where he has a constant velocity. So then now we have to sort of include acceleration to see what acceleration would look like. So I'm just going to put, let's say, accelerating for 4 meters per second square. And you can see that, well, he's getting faster and faster. I don't want him to run out of room. You can see the velocity at this point. He is at negative and then 0, and then the next one is gets increasingly higher, higher and higher because he's increasing velocity. And how does that look in a displacement time graph? Because he is moving faster and faster and faster away from the origin, faster from every time. Instead of a linear sort of slope, it has more of a curve because he's actually increasing his displacement faster and faster. So that's a good way to use moving man to help you see what that looked like. Let's try just play around with a bunch of numbers. Let's see what that, oh, okay, he's just moving around. This is going back. and then negative velocity. You can see once he passed this point, he has moved beyond the origin. So back to origin, below, above origin, below, like a yo-yo, look at that. So that's your velocity time graph. Hopefully this video helped you understand velocity time graph. So see you later.